Some call it a case of bullying, but the damage was done by words and keystrokes instead of punches. Parents say that some local teens used the popular social media site Facebook to create a webpage that bashed a 13-year-old special needs classmate. As 4029's Joe Ellison found out, some of what was written could be against the law. Joe?
It's the comment students made that can be illegal. The page itself was started by students at Butterfield Junior High in Van Buren, and it's caused outrage from parents all over our community.
It's not right to use someone's disabilities.
This is Harrison Warren, a 13-year-old Butterfield Junior High student. He likes to play the tuba, and his parents say he has special needs. He came home from school yesterday telling them about a Facebook page friends created just for him.
He was told that it was a club made just for him on Facebook, and he was excited.
But that wasn't the case. Jenny and James Wilson found this.
The page specifically was titled Harrison is a retard, and it was set up to specifically ridicule and harass our son.
Around 50 students at Butterfield became a fan.
These were my friends. They told me that they were my friends.
Some offering harsh words and comments.
I hate to see my child hurt needlessly. You know, there's kids being kids, and there's a step beyond that.
The Wilsons say it was a hate group against their son.
We want there to be consequences for actions like this. Children that maliciously seek to hurt another child.
The Wilsons emailed parents. Some apologized for their children's actions. Today, Van Buren police took action.
We've got the page down. We've identified those that are involved.
School officials had no comment since the page was not created on school property. The Wilsons, though, are hoping for a fresh start.
Our son will not be returning to Butterfield.
Now, police are not releasing the name of the parents whose child created the page, but do say they were cooperative. And as of 3 o'clock, Craig, today the page was removed.
Okay, that's good news. Thank you, Joe. Police say the case will now go to the prosecutor, who will determine if any charges might be filed.